It seems that all the paths in the forest are blocked by guards. Julian's leading them, but they won't have the courage to go through the swamps. If we make it through safely, we'll reach Scarlet Meadows. It's a small village with few people, but we'll have a roof over our heads for the night. We just need to read this map right so we can find our way. Though without a compass, it's a guessing game.
That's why there's a guard at every road turn. Now I see. Ha! Oh, by the way, I'm Germaine, the village chief. This cart holds the only food we have left, and if I can't get it to the village, my people will starve. But the cart is busted, and the path is covered in some kind of enchanted roots. Oh my, what am I going to do?
We should help. We can't let people perish like that. I'll hold the cart while you look for the wheel that rolled away, all right?
Yes, isn't that something? Recently, a shamaness has set up a camp in our village, living in a tent and telling fortunes. If you want, I'll give you the directions. Great. Just go to the nearest bridge, and you can't miss it. Oh, but know this. She requires everyone to bring their own handmade runes to read the future.
Thank you.
thank you. You saved me and the village. How can I repay you for your kind help, Your Royal Highness? Yes, I may be old, but I'm certainly not blind. Of course I recognize you. So, what is it that I can do for you, my lady? Looks like the rumors about your humbleness were true. Anyway, you'll give us no trouble if your companion disguises himself. Could you find something for him to cover his horns and claws before entering the inn? And here, please take this as a special gift to thank you for your help.
Thank you.
Thank you, Aurora. When I hide my face, for a brief moment I think I'm a normal person again. But I am what I am. A beast. And there's no changing that. You're very kind, Aurora. Your heart sees more than the eyes of the people around here. One way or another, we need to find a place to lay our heads for the night. Now people won't be scared of me, so we can go to the inn. And here, take this. I found it in the swamp.
Hey, you, peasant. One of my guards saw a hideous beast near your village. Tell me where it is this second.
Forgive me, my lord, but there are no beasts in this village.
Don't you dare lie to me. My boys have scoured every scrap of this land, and there's nowhere else for him to hide. The beast is definitely here, and if you won't help me, old man, I'll have my soldiers raise this village to the ground.
This village was built by the king's order and will only be destroyed by one.
Aurora, please, stay here. I need to help the villagers.
You beast! Prince Julian wants you arrested.
Help! The flame will destroy our supplies, and we'll have nothing to eat. And if the fire spreads, we'll all be homeless! Oh, you are so very kind and noble. Thank you, dear sir. Thank you. If it weren't for you, the villagers would have starved. And they've already suffered enough during the war with the witches. The evil hags burned the crops, cursed the cattle. Good thing the king and the knights were able to chase them away, and peace returned to the lands. Princess Aurora is a very kind woman, and many people would like to see her as the new queen when the time comes. then this. Prince Julian showed up. An arrogant and spiteful young man. And a foreigner at that. Oh, I'm so worried about him hurting someone in the village. Perhaps you can find and subdue him. Because I believe that if there's a beast here, then it's him, not you. Meanwhile, I will make sure that the fire didn't do too much damage to the houses and that the villagers are safe.
Thank you.
you don't surrender now, beast, I'll kill him and blame it on you. Then I'll return Aurora home, and the king will easily believe that the monster who kidnapped her was also you. He'll be convinced that I am the best match for his lovely daughter in marriage. That's right. Put your hands up, keep quiet, and don't come any closer. My forces are about to reach the village and arrest you.
You are truly gracious, my noble sir.
Silence, peasant. He can't save you.
Even the beast has more mercy than this crowned thug.
Thank you.
Thank you for saving me. The king will know of your kindness.
Thank you, Sir Adrian. Now I know that Julian is not worthy of Aurora's hand in marriage. In such a short time, he managed to set a village on fire and attack innocent people. I will break the agreement with the Kingdom of Greenhold and expose Julian's misdeeds to his father. Aurora was much wiser than me. I was wrong not to choose her as the heir to the throne, and I will shortly remedy that.
Father, Adrian has saved me several times and helped the villagers. I've come to have feelings for him.
Aurora, no beast can be your husband. And certainly one can't rule this kingdom. You are the future queen, and your choices should be wiser.
His Majesty is right, Aurora. I'm not worthy of your hand. But one day, I truly hope I will be.
Adrian, that no one would lift his curse. Fool! He will always be a beast. Oh, and that princess. She can't break my spell. As love always requires a sacrifice. A truly terrible one.